you have access to more learning resources than nearly anyone in history. The trouble is, oftentimes it can seem that with such a selection, such an assortment of resources available, that you don't know which ones to choose from. You could not study all that there is to study, all that you have available within a lifetime. So how do you choose what to spend your time learning? How do you choose where to direct your resources, your time, your energy and efforts? Sure, there's your own searching, internet, library, asking friends and family. One way that I've especially enjoyed recently because of how much time it saves is hiring an expert, hiring someone who has the answers that I'm looking for. And I realized something today. I was studying with a foreign language teacher through Verbling, and in that lesson, this teacher shared with me multiple resources for how we were going to spend our classes going forward, how we were going to focus on learning this language. And this teacher opened two links that she had bookmarked and was sharing the screen with me to show me this is what we're going to go through. These resources I may never have found if I had been searching on my own. This teacher, this expert, had searched on her own in the past. This teacher had exposure to what other teachers have been doing, what works, what doesn't work. And she has distilled that information into this lesson to take what she finds to be the most effective way of teaching this language and share it with me. Consider the amount of time, the amount of effort that went into coming to this conclusion, to understanding what would be necessary, what the best is. Do you want to spend that time on your own? This is an example of the benefit of a private contractor, of hiring an expert, a freelancer. In this example, it's related to foreign languages. If you're studying a foreign language, perhaps you're doing it entirely on your own. Perhaps you have a budget that doesn't allow you to afford a private tutor. Understand this, these tutors on Verbling and other sites, they usually offer free trials. These trials are heavily discounted, last a half hour instead of an hour, and allow you to get an introduction to what the course or what this area of study with this teacher is going to be like in the long run, what their approach is. You can use that time, as I have, for multiple languages that I don't intend to study intensely. You can use that time to ask other questions. You can use that time to get insight from that person about the language, about the country that they're in, about the economy of the country that they're in, about trends that they're noticing in their day-to-day life, personal, individual, cultured insight. You have access to this, and it doesn't take that much money to do this, but it saves you a lot of time. So if you're trying to learn a language, instead of trying to look on a blog that shows you top resources for learning a language, not that they're wrong, but from what I've seen, a lot of these reviews of different resources come down to somebody giving it a try on staff for a few months and writing what their experience was. Compare that to a teacher who has to fight for their job every day. Somebody who is only going to earn money if students keep coming back to them. Why does a student keep coming back to them? If they are learning, if they are succeeding in the task that they hired the freelancer for in the first place. That is, in this case, learning the language. So there is a financial incentive for teachers to learn the most effective method for you to learn the language. That is what you get access to when you talk with one of these teachers. That is what you get access to in other areas when you hire an independent consultant. They are looking to differentiate themselves to be competitive in the industry, and the only way that happens is to your benefit, learning what works most effectively. You can get access to that. Not only this, not only with languages, but you can learn about tools. You can learn about things that exist that you weren't aware of before. I work as a software engineer, and over time, I've learned about tools that exist that help my workflow, that make me a more productive coder, third-party tools that I can incorporate into my workflow, plugins that I would use on websites that I would build. I learned about these steadily. And if you're in this field, you probably have too, be it on forums or on learning websites like lynda.com or the LinkedIn Learning. But consider this, consider instead going to upwork.com or to LinkedIn and finding someone in the field right now, someone who offers their services in consultation form, who is working in the field that you are in or in the industry that you want to be in, who's using the technologies that you're learning or that you want to learn. You can reference them. You can set up a call with them. You can hire them for them to share with you what they've learned in their experience. And then you're not getting it piecemeal. Then you're not getting it portion by portion over months or years. You're getting it at once distilled into a pure form, an effective form. And why is it? Where do they get this? They are looking for the most effective way to do their job, because the better they do their job, the more likely they are to keep the job they're already working, and or the more likely they're going to be hired by another company, the more likely they're going to advance, to move up in their company. Or it's a tool that's going to allow them to have a competitive advantage compared to a competitor. Just like with the language teacher, there is a financial incentive for them to learn what is most effective, and you can get access to that. These are just two examples: language, programming, or web development. You only have so much time. How much of it do you want to spend exploring compared to reaping the rewards of discovery? To go back to the example of the language teacher, here's another example of something that you may not have considered for why you should go to Verbling or to some other language learning website and find a freelancer that you can start interacting with, because they can be a gateway into a new country. In the past, I've looked up jobs in other countries, how to move abroad, how to get sponsored for a worker visa or an entrepreneurship visa. Now, this isn't a separate subject. This isn't unrelated. It happens alongside the subject of getting that visa. You see, alongside of those processes, alongside of me seeking out answers to how can I stand out in the international market? How can I work in another country? It helps to know someone in that country. And what's a way that you can meet people in that country? Hire them. Hire their services. If you don't have a product that you need them to build, product that they can come alongside what you're doing and be hired as a freelancer or a contractor in that way, you can hire them in the form of a consultation. This is a way of getting to know them, to get perspective from another country, another industry, another area in life, another stage in life. You have access to this. Along the way, you may discover through that interaction, through that consultation, or through hiring their services, you may discover realities about that country of interest related to your investment strategy, related to your trying to get hired in that country, related to you trying to start a business in that country, related to you trying to sell your services internationally to that country. One of the best parts is you're not wasting time. There are additional benefits besides the strictly related to business. And that was what I found out when I was speaking with my language teacher today. She shared that she has students from across the world who she encourages to visit her in her country, to visit the country in general. And when they do, they meet for coffee. There's somebody in her country that these people trying to learn that language know. Have you ever gone to a country where you didn't know anyone, where you didn't have a point of reference besides perhaps the internet, a map, a local guide? This could be even if you're trying to travel. You gain at most a resource, at the least a friend. And so this teacher has a new student about every month come to visit her city, and in doing so, they meet for coffee. I wonder what those conversations are like, but I'm looking forward to having one.